Благослови душе моя, Господи. Thank you. Lord, save the pious in heart and unto all. Богу, о Израиле есть во спасение, свидетельствую во им, яко ревность Божия имут, но не по разуму, не разумеющего Божия правды, и свою правду ищущи поставите, правде Божией не повинувшися, кончина во закона Христос, правду всякому верующему, Моисей Бог пишет правды уже от закона, яко сотворил и та человек, жив будет мир, а я же от веры правда сице глаголит, да не речеши в сердце твоем, кто взыдет на небо сиречь Христа свести, или кто снидет в бездну сиречь Христа от мертвых возвести, но что глаголит Писание, плести глагол есть во устех твоих и в сердце твоем, сиречь глагол веры и Божия проповедем. Я плащи исповеси в усты твои Господа Иисуса, и верующий в сердце твоем, яко Бог того воздвижи из мертвых, спасающийся, сердцем бо веруется в правду, усты же исповедятся во спасение. И духа и твоему,
and there was a good way off from them, and for the ministry Братья, это лежащие. пощади, пощади люди твои, не помни до конца. Смиренно молимся, услыши, помилуй.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
И во доме смерти владычь своему, Господи, не затвори, в смерти душа работай, но пристанем не восстави яром за нечи, за некоторые дни наши, и ищи крепость наша. И погибаем до конца века ради нашей милости, будь рабом твоим, пока я не со слезами молимся, услыши и помилуй.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Слабые человеческие исправляем, Господи, прежде милости на рабы твоя. Михаил, на паре имя, сонно на поле, все путешествия, все на мешках, мы с ним простим всякое прегрешение, вольно же невольным, благослови, благоволение, советы, их исходы, в полису путешествия, не справи, прилежно молим, все услышишь и помилуй.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Сохранитесь со святыми христианским людям, освятителями, сущим от осквернения, разорения, адными, всякие беды, церкви, Господи, услыши скоро, помилуй.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Неводя и смерти грешну, но ожидаю обращения, покаяния, обратимся от души, посреди твоей церкви, молитесь о милосердии, Господи, услыши и помилуй.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Правый заповедь твой нам, ежели любите Бога нашими ближними своему, сотвори за ненависти, враждой, видом за их проклятого присутства и прочее беззаконие прекратятся, истинная же любовь да царствует в сердцах наших. Молитесь о Спасителе нашу, слыши милость на нам, помилуй.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Еще молимся Тебе, Господи, Богу нашему, и еже услышите сей глас, умоление наше, молитва и помилуйте рабов Твоих. Антония, 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 Ольни, 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 благодать и щедро Твоими, исполните вся прошение их, простите им вся согрешение, вольное и невольное. Благ вам приятным же быть и молитвам милостивым их пред престолом Владычества Твоему, и покрытие им от прах, видимых, невидимых, от всякой напасти, беды и скорби, недугов избавите. И подарки здравия, дома детства, церкви, Господи, помилуй.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Прошу души Тебя с умилением сердца, с удушами Тебя припадами, с нашего клиента, исцели, болезнью, врачу, страсти, души Тебя с рабов Твоих. Митрополита Ларион и Нерман, архиепископа Кирилла Петра, епископа Неомия, архимандрита Иосия, Фима, Антония, Бенедикта, протоиерея Андрея, Михаила Сеня, протодиакона Николая, диакона Виталия, Льва, подиакона Сеня, рабов Божьих, Ольми, Натальи, Юлии, Любови, Льва, Татьяны, Лани, Анны, Николая, Веры, Ольми, Натальи, Сусанны, Софии, Латины, Елизаветы, Виктора, Виктории, Михаила, Иоанны, Владимира, Александра, Анны, Анны, Ирины, Марии, Елены, Сергия, Стефана, Серафима, Александра, Антония, Якова, Анны, Елены, Лидии, Ольги, Гарри, Ксении. И все болящие святого храма, Симой, простим, Якове, мое сердце, от прегрешения, вольное и невольное. И скоро воздвигнет от раболезни, молим, ты все услыши, помилуй.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Еще молимся, подносящий, добродеющий, восхитимся, честнем, храм, всем нуждающимся, боящих, предстоящих людей, ожидающих от Тебя великие, богатые милости.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
murder and drunkenness, bitter disputes and scandals, anger on our hearts, every impurity, conflict, and evil. That again we all may love one another and abide as one in thee, O Lord our God, as thou hast commanded and directed us. Grant peace to thy church and to her children, that with one heart and one mouth we may glorify thee, our Lord and Savior, unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Amen.
And again,
Kristno i veki vekov. Blaženičego Anuhrija, mitropolita Kijevskego i svija Ukrajini, i straž duši u pasku jego, da pomine kroz Bogu po carstvi svojem, sedani i prisno i veki vekov. Benedešti Voskresenje i žizni večni rod svojih, novopredstavljenih mitropolita Mitrofana i Rava Božja Petra, da pomine kroz Bogu po carstvi svojem, Сидані і присні до віки веков, священство, монашество, секоніми і стражущихся віру православною, создателі і благословителі, против сестричества і боющихся того храма сего, і всіх вас, православних християн, да поміне Господь Бог по царстві своєм, сидані і присні до віки веков.
Thank you.
помилуй.
Якобы человек любит Бог наш, приеми его святый, пренебесный мысли свой жертвенник, твоему благоухание духовного вознесвозрит нам божественную благодать. И дар Святаго Духа помолимся.
Господи, помилуй.
Избавимся нам от всяких скорби, гнева и нужды, Господу помолимся.
Господи, помилуй.
Заступи, спаси, помилуй, сохрани нас, Боже, Твоей благодатью.
Господи, помилуй.
Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, today we gather in the parish church and we hear a reading from the Gospel of Matthew. This particular instance is also recorded in Luke, and so we hear it twice a year, and therefore we've heard two sermons about it every year for essentially as long as we've been coming to church. And we know it pretty well, and for most of us it's pretty clear what the message is. But I think it's important for us to, when we think that we know everything, be certain that we don't. And we think that when we think we've got it just right, look and see if there's something a little bit deeper. Today's gospel is about those people on the Sea of Galilee who kept pigs. Right? They were Jewish people and they kept pigs because that's where the big money was. Right? That was the marijuana of their day, I guess, or whatever. You know, so that's where the big money was. And the thing about pigs, though, is that that is against the Mosaic law. So as Jews, they should not eat them, not even touch them. Right? And this was, of course, for the Hebrew people, an opportunity for obedience. In the Old Testament, it says obedience is higher than sacrifice. And if you read the Old Testament, it's pretty obvious that there's really nothing higher than sacrificing in the Temple of Jerusalem. That's like a lifelong desire for most people, especially people who live so far from Jesus. They couldn't just kind of scoot down to Jerusalem. It's many hours in a bus. That's the only way that I've ever traveled it. But walking, it must be days. So they were sort of off on the edge, away from the center of the population where the Temple of Solomon was. And they got into this really lucrative work of raising pigs against the law. So the Lord comes to them, and they have some possessed people there. And he heals them, and how does he heal them? This is actually referred to in the baptismal service, and thank God we've been doing baptisms like crazy lately. It's referred to there, and he sends the demons into their herd of swine, and they run down a cliff and into the water and drown. And so their living is ruined, but their people are saved. And so they go into the city, and they tell everybody about that. It's actually just a village there. And then they all come back, and they're all excited, and they say, "Go away. We don't want you here anymore." And of course, most of us are not so mercenary in our lives that we would be like, "Well, I'm doing this thing which is against the law, but I'm making big money. And, that's okay, because somehow I feel like in my delusion that Christianity allows me." Okay? But most of us don't have such delusions. We just have smaller, much smaller delusions. Or we think they're smaller, but maybe they're even the same size. We can talk about it and see. We don't, when faced with the Lord's many miracles, say, "Go away from us, Lord. We don't want you here." We don't do that. That's why we're here. We're coming to God's house. But if we're honest about it, I think that a lot of times we do kind of say, "Lord, go away," or "Look over there, because I have to do something here. So be attentive there, because you're not part of this." And especially when it comes to accepting God's will, or trying to align our will to God's. Because we get into this mistaken paradigm that our will is equal to God's, or, probably if we're honest, our will is greater than God's. At least more important and wiser. And this is where I think we have to be really careful. Because it's not like we're out, well, now marijuana is legal, but some other illicit drug, doing that and making big money for that. As far as I don't know, nobody in the parish is doing that. And I think that most people are trying to live honorably and have an honorable life. And that's good, and that's what we should do. But a lot of times, I think that we, at least I'm all about God's will until it doesn't conform to mine. And then it's the decision that has to be made. Do I go with my great wisdom or that very small suggestion that God is making that I might want to pay attention to? Of course, I'm joking, because it's completely the other way around. So often, we sort of brush off God when it comes to the big
big stuff, but you know, God, if you make those tomatoes go away, thank you for that. That's wonderful. Okay, that's not. It's good. Tomatoes. I mean, if you're making a living on tomatoes, but most of us aren't. We've got to get it the other way around. It's kind of like with our sins and our family. We're supposed to hate sin and love our family. But a lot of times, the way that we live, we actually do it the other way. We show that we love our sin, and I don't know, we hate our family, but it can be like an inconvenience sometimes. And sometimes we even, you know, treat them wrong, poorly. It's very important for us, when we hear these Gospels, twice a year, essentially. I mean, you know, like St. Latimer Day could fall on this Sunday, it's possible. Or even the next, or the one before. So this could get moved like once in a great while. We can hear it twice a year. But anyway, we hear at least once a year this Gospel. We should reflect and see, how are we being like those people that the Lord points out to us in today's Gospel? Because he didn't do that for fun. It wasn't just like, I don't have anything to do now, let's do this. That was for our salvation. Right? Everything that's in the Scripture, that's for the salvation of the people who were there then. But it's also for us. So there's nothing that's frivolous or useless in the Gospel. Everything that's there is important for our salvation. So sometimes it's really obvious. Like, it's not even much of a parable. It's clear what we're supposed to do. Go forth and do that. Or it's clear what we're not supposed to do and go forth and don't do that. But I think today is one of those days. And thank God for that. Where the Lord allows us to exercise the excellent brain that he's given us. And to reflect, not just with our brain, but with our heart. How does this Gospel reflect me? What part might I be playing in inviting the Lord to go away from me? Because very few of us are actively doing that, like these people, as I mentioned. But in small ways, we often do that. And I think it's something we have to be careful about. Lots of small sins, lots of small falls can equal something great. And moreover, if we think of sins as rocks, so a little rock, a little tiny pebble, you put that in the pocket, or some piece of sand. And eventually it starts to get just as heavy as a boulder. But the person who carries the boulder, their one sin to confession, can easily throw it out. How long it takes to clean out those pockets? When you go to the beach and you get the sand in there, it takes a long time. Let's start by not putting any more sand in the pockets, but striving to fulfill God's will as much as we can, and striving to never be as these people and ask the Lord to go away from us, whether it's something big or something small, whether it's something that we perceive as good or something that we perceive as bad. Because what comes from God is all good. It's just us. We decide that goes in the bad column, this goes in the good column. But what's coming is everything that's best for our salvation. And so therefore, from God's point of view, it's good. Let's strive, brothers and sisters, in the light of today's Gospel, to also see everything that the Lord is giving us as good. And if we make a small effort in this regard, and we ask the Lord's help, we can begin to have small success upon small success, which will lead to greater and greater success, which will lead us to the heavenly. May the Lord grant this to all of us. Amen.
Thank you. voluntary and involuntary, of word and of deed, committed in knowledge or in ignorance, and make me worthy to partake without condemnation of thy most pure mysteries, for the remission of my sins, and unto life everlasting. Amen. Of thy mystical supper, O Son of God, accept me today as a communicant, for I will not speak of thy mystery to thy enemies, neither like Judas will I give thee a kiss, but like the thief will I confess thee. Remember me, O Lord, in thy kingdom. May the communion of thy holy mysteries be neither to my judgment nor to my condemnation, O Lord, but to the healing of soul and body. Amen. Verum vos prodis, prodeu Iacotis, si volis tino Christos in voce vada, ricevi me perecnis pastia, tince bebi es mas. Ieshe verum Iacotis amis pricis rei telo poia, isias amis cisnaia cro poia, maius abrefer paninia e prestinia pregrishenia moia polonia e nevolnia, я же словом, я же делом, я же ведением и неведением. И с дороги меня не осужденно причаститеся причистый Твой конец, о восстановлении Бога в жизнь вечную. Аминь. Вечный Твой конец, и не Божий причастник, и причастник меня по имени, не могу рабом Твоим тайного, не дал взамен для меня приюта, но я по разбойник исповедую Тебя по имени Господи во Царстве Твоем. Да не в суде и в осуждении будет мне причащение святых Твоих тайн, Господи, на Твоей вселенной души и тела.
blessed Father, bless.
In Christ our true God, who rose from the dead to the intercessions of his most pure mother, the holy, glorious, and all praised apostles, our Father among the saints, John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, the holy martyrs of Proclus and Hilary of Ankara, the whole our venerable and God-bearing Father Michael, the holy equal to the apostles, great prince, blood on the earth, the holy righteous ancestors of God, who came in and of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us for his good and the lover of mankind.
Amen. Our great Lord and Father, his holiness herein, nature ever was God and all Russia, our Lord, the very most servant, Hilarion, metropolitan of Eastern America, New York, prescribed from the Russian church abroad, our Lord, the most reverend Peter, Archbishop of Chicago and Mid-America, and their God, protect and flock, his land and civil authorities and our forces, that God preserve Russia and land, the rector of this holy parish and all the restrictions, praise our well heart for many.
The wedding of Innocent Court and Charmaine Costin that will take place here at St. Vladimir's on this coming Friday, the 30th of July. Congratulate Reader David and Chloe with the baptism of their son Blaise. The godfather is our starista, Jack Mitchell. The baptism took place in the hospital. Blaise is threatening to leave at any time, and I think they caught him sneaking out once, but it will be not very long, God willing, and he'll be able to leave there. I can testify with my own eyes. He doesn't even look like a preemie at all anymore. He just looks like a regular baby. So please continue to pray for him. But now we can pray for him among the Orthodox Christians. That's helpful for him and the public is helpful for us too. Thank you to everyone who made our vacation Bible school such a success this week. We had a really great week, really wonderful lessons, really great time for the kids. So a lot of people worked to make that possible, and we thank you all for doing that. Ann Arbor Class 4 at the Rex Academy. Work continues when we can get contractors to work. God willing, that's going to continue in these next couple of weeks. But it's pretty obvious that we're not going to be having classes this fall in the school. But we are going to be having classes, and there's going to be more information coming soon on that. So please continue to pray for the success of this project. The Lord sent us a pandemic and a labor shortage as a challenge, and we have to thank him for that, according to the sermon I just gave, and just see that somehow his hand is in this. In any case, there will be classes this year, and more information will be coming about that soon. Fasting this week, Wednesday and Friday are fast days. Wednesday is our parish feast day. That does not absolve us of fasting, but it will be about as light a fast as you can have, of course, with a portion of wine, so I'm sure that's not good enough. Cemetery spaces are available. Please make sure that you arrange that at the earliest opportunity. You can pay for the space over time, so you don't have to have a bunch of cash together to buy it. Talk to me or Constantine or Jack about that today. Festival news, the next workday is this coming Saturday at 10 o'clock, and we hope that we'll have a really great turnout like we did last time. It was a lot of fun. A We'll also have the sign up to volunteer for the festival available today. So please make sure that you sign up if you haven't already. Some of those venues are full. So if you really love emptying the garbage, let's say before, I think there might be one more slot left there. But some of them are full. So please sign up today. Marina will have the sign up sheet. Is there anything else that you wanted to say about the festival?
So as usual, we'll have our t-shirts, and if you would like to purchase them at cost, please let Sinjana know. She'll let us about the deadline, but you have to tell her that how many of the sizes you would like. And I suggest old shirts or t-shirts, let them be wearing them, because it works. Every time we bring people, ask, oh, it's a festival in Arbor. It's in September. If you just tell them what date, they will forget, but they can find it. They say, yes, it's September, we can just come, and they just, oh, okay. So just all those shirts, they're still in use. Keep wearing them.
Good. Thank you, Marina. This week, we're going to have a little, just a slight deviation from our regular schedule. Instead of serving on Saturday morning, this week we'll serve on Friday morning. This is the Feast of Great Mara Marina. It's Marina's name's day, actually. And all margaritas also celebrate on that day. So instead of Friday night, Saturday morning at the end of the week, this week it'll be Thursday night, Friday morning. So please make note of that. Any other announcements that we need? Okay, great. We need to sing Many Years for those who celebrated their name's days this week. Some people are sly about that, and they have their name's day on their birthday. Like Ola Fildman, who turned 96 yesterday. But we don't sing Many Years for birthday. We sing happy birthday. We sing Many Years for the name's day. So what are we going to do? We're going to do Many Years now, and we'll sing Happy Birthday at the meal. And somebody else also celebrated their birthday today. It might be one of the people who's going to be intoning this way. There's only one person. I guess it was you. Happy birthday. We'll sing Happy Birthday also for Father Vladimir. So stay with us, yes, brothers and sisters, please, for our meal. Let's sing Many Years for those who celebrate the meal today.
Благо несколько дней здравия, спасения всем моему посвящению по нашему Господи рабу Твоим. Восприми Алексеяно просвященному Васию, Антонию, 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 Ольни, 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 и сохрани их на много лет.
Powers of my soul.
Please join us at the appropriate time. Young adults, please come for dinner and please let us know.